Hello there, it's Ash, and today I wanted to quickly review my latest purchase from Fashionphile. Again, I purchased this bag specifically so that I could show you guys how I would clean this vachette leather, so I'm completely fine with all the stains and watermarks. But I really wanted to go through this bag entirely so that I could share my thoughts on how the previous owner could have gotten these stains on the bag. And let's get started with the top handles. They actually look really good on this bag. There's not a lot of dirt on the handles, which is surprising because you actually see that a lot on a speedy handle. So that must mean that this previous owner used the shoulder strap option a lot. Now there is a visible mark on one of the handles. I believe it's from the handle actually rubbing against the canvas, and I found this to be really odd. So now I'm really curious if this actually does happen a lot with bags that have these vachette top handles. Now there are other areas on the handles that have dirt, and these look like they are occurring because of the leather rubbing against tarnishing hardware. For example, there are rivets on the chaps, and this one specifically, when it comes to contact, it just does this. And there's also this area, which I have no idea what you would call it, but it's got more stains on both sides because the shoulder strap ring is scratched up and also tarnished, so they are constantly in contact with the leather handles in this area. So I'm honestly really hoping that if I clean the hardware, that it will minimize these stains in the future. In regards to the stitch chaps, I did notice that there is watermarks, but there are also stains, dirt, and even wear and tear around the edges of the square rings. Now this bag did come with a key bell. Again, I knew that it would come with a stain in the front, but I honestly had no idea that there would be also one in the back. I'm also not quite sure how these stains occurred, but I'm actually hoping that by deep cleaning it, it will remove this dirt or stain. Next up is the square base. Fashionphile actually did not show the back of this bag, so I'm going to start there. This side actually has tons of watermarks, which you can see. There are also some stains on top of the watermarks. I'm honestly not sure what these can be from. Again, there are more areas with stains, and if you do look along the bottom edge, there are also dark visible dirt there, so I'm definitely going to have to clean this to remove all of that dirt. The leather also looks really shiny. Usually this leather is untreated, so I'm going to again have to clean this to reduce these oils. As for the other side, you've got similar watermarks all over the leather, but there are more noticeable stains. First of all, we have these two here on the left side, which could be from the key. It could also be burned leather or even stains from food. I honestly don't know. Again, more stains. These feel actually raised, so I'm hoping they're not fly specks. Anyways, there are more watermarks and the same dirt along the edge of this leather. As for the shoulder sides, they do have reinforced leather. This one actually has nothing on it, but you can actually see there is a watermark. And then on the other side, it does have the Louis Vuitton trademark hot stamped. Of course, because it was made in 2014, it does also indicate what country it was made, which is France. Again, you'll also see more stains on this leather, but aside from that, it does look perfect. So now we're at the bottom of the bag, and I honestly hate that Fashionphile takes pictures at this perspective because you can't see the shape of the bottom. It is rectangular with rounded corners. But again, there are watermarks or water rings around the edges and at the corner of the bag. It is very minimal, and that's because this bag has feet. Again, the leather doesn't have much dirt because of the feet, so I love that about this bag. But there are scuffs on the leather along the edges. This actually happens to all the Almas, but again, on this bag, it is very minimal, so I know I can easily care for it. In regards to hardware, again, the Alma BB has four gold-colored feet. These studs protect all the delicate vachette leather at the bottom of the bag, but you'll see after a few years they have developed scratches and the gold tip of the stud has rubbed off. Now also on the stud you'll see it's engraved with Louis Vuitton, but you'll also see that there is a monogram flower for authenticity. Next, there are square rings which attach the top handles to the bag. They have hairline scratches all over them, which look normal, but one does look like it's tarnishing quite a bit. The rivets also secure the chaps, and they all look perfect, but again, I am noticing some tarnishing. It's actually the ring where the shoulder straps are attached that bothered me the most. They have the most significant amount of wear and tear. They look like scratches, but it's odd because they don't feel deep at all. The hardware still feels very smooth. So again, I think it could just be tarnishing, which I'm honestly hoping some Brasso will fix. Again, this bag has a zipper closure. The zipper teeth has a small amount of tarnishing, but it still looks great if you don't clean them. There are also two zippers, so you can close the bag in either direction. The zipper pulls, which have the Louis Vuitton monogram on them, look great, but again, I can see some areas of tarnishing. Now, there is also a very unique slider, which allows you to fold the zipper pull over to secure the bag, but the holes where you insert the padlock does have a significant amount of wear because the previous owner did store the padlock there. So I'm going to try to clean this a little bit later and see if it'll remove some of that dirt. The key also looks great, so that must mean that the previous owner really did use the key belt to store the key. As for the padlock, there are hairline scratches on it, and again, it is tarnished a little bit. As for the interior lining, it is in brown, and it does have a distinct old scent to it. I don't even know how to describe it, but it's there, and I'm going to clean it so that I can get rid of it. But the lining looks very good overall. It just has this odd side. I don't know what it is, but it could be the reason why the canvas on the outside looks a little bit weird. It was also indicated that there would be liquid marks on the lining. Again, I don't know what this is. It could be glue, it could be gel, a glitter pin. I'm not sure, but it's very shiny, and I hope I can remove it. There are also some stains. These could be pen marks. I see some in red, black, and pink. So again, I will be using Amodex to remove them. So the interior also has one flat slip pocket, and it is actually a small pocket. You cannot fit a cargo holder in here, which is surprising. But there's also a leather tab in here, which has the date code. And on this piece, it says CT, which stands for the country of which it was made, and that is France. And then the last four numbers are pretty much like when it was produced. These two numbers represent the week, which is the 15th week, and then the last two numbers represent the year. So again, 15th week of 2014 would be sometime around April, making this bag around 8 years old. Finally, for the canvas, I can see that it's been stretched. It looks really bumpy. Again, I'm not sure if it's because of the lining inside, but it still feels very sturdy, so I'm fine with that. The texture of the canvas also looks similar to what I've seen. There are no stains, scuffs, or scratches on the print, but the only concern I have is how the canvas and the leather looks overall. It is very shiny, and I honestly believe because it's been only 8 years that the previous owner must have used baby wipes to clean this bag. Baby wipes again contain 1% of a moisturizing ingredient which can make this shiny surface develop, so I will be stripping it with my deep cleaning method, and I hope it will look like my other Louis Vuitton bags with this type of vachette leather. Overall, I am very happy about this purchase, and I love the condition of this pre-owned bag. I'm actually really excited to experiment on the leather and see if I can restore this bag, even though I know it looks great already. Now, if you're interested in purchasing a pre-owned bag for yourself, I'll include a link to Fashionphile in my info box. But that's pretty much it for today. Thanks again so much for watching. I'm Ash, and I'll see you guys next time.